Reasons Invest. So based on my first video 4 months ago, I guess it's been a while since I update you guys on the profits, so I guess it's a great time right now. So actually there is something going on with OXBTC. So as you can know, OXBTC originated from China, and what is happening now is that there is two articles coming in separate intervals. So first article was they banned crypto mining, second article was they actually prevented any form of OTC trading for China citizens on Huobi, OKX, etc. So the coin actually really dropped for a period of time. So now it's after the drop of Bitcoin price. Currently Bitcoin sitting at 55k. So looking at the profits that this is the free one that I don't think it was free. I think I probably paid a few dollars. Let's see how much I actually got from here. So you can see that I'm consistently earning about a 1 or 2 cents from this for the newcomer. They actually entitled to buy a small hash rate to try, so it's consistently paying me profits. That's a thing. And for the one that I actually spent money to buy was this one. So right now, on average, based on today's Bitcoin price, I'm actually generating about $2.80 a day. But it's a bit sad because the true reason why I'm not generating as high as I thought I would be is because that let's see their official announcement. So they have been actually relocating their mining farms after the news from China that they are not allowed to mine in China. So they tried to actually move to Texas, etc. So during the moving stage, some of the machines were under maintenance or actually scrap. So right now we are under this share together program, and you can see that the Bitcoin that I'm earning a day, about $2.80, is actually 60% of the machines running, and then they divided the total hash rate by a share. So I think that for Ethereum as well, it's about very low, it's like 31%. So from my consistent observation is that the A farm has a lot of issues, and I'm glad they are moving away from A farm, because this literally, like when A farm was on, this became 60%. So I believe that after we move, we will get much more profits, and it will be very worthwhile to actually start investing in the BTC mining over here. So that time when we were talking about it was like $100 to get a hash rate. So 78.80 I think is a decent rate. Personally for me, I wouldn't want to invest because I already bought. So for you, maybe you can just try 1 terahash for fun, or you can, I don't recommend the short term lah, because after all, 166 days is a very, you're putting a constraint on your return on investment timeline. So personally would rather pay double, because imagine you just operating this for 1 year, you most probably earn more than the S19 model. So for people who want to try the Filecoin, there is you can only buy 0.1 terabyte, so actually try to click, doesn't work. So you can get like maybe 20 cents a day for this, and the best thing is you're gonna get like 99 cents. So it means you have to pay $3.99 first. So what I did was I used my profit, $2.80, for a few days, then it accumulated to $3, right? Then I purchased this Filecoin here. So this is back to our profit hash rate. And so the Filecoin earlier, right, you saw it was $3.99. So there is proof that I actually received $3 back here. But the tricky thing is I couldn't withdraw this because the minimum withdrawal for USDT is 5 USD. So I might consider topping up to actually buy some cheaper hash rate, or like 1 or 2 hash rate. So you can realize that actually just now, right, when we tried to look at ETH mining, there were no ETH mining anymore because of the ETH 2.0. So the Ethereum that I'm holding, right, I'm just trying to actually profit along the way. So you can see that this was what happened after the mine A stopped mining. So right now I'm profiting at about $1 plus for Ethereum, maybe 170 per day US dollars, and I think it's quite a bad buy to be frank. So I think that maybe in the long run this hash rate can be diverted to, let's say, Ravencoin, etc. So I'm not very sure what's their plan, so I can only hope for the best. So right now I'm quite glad that they have stock up their BTC mining at such an affordable rate, so you guys can actually just try the BTC one, because 60% operating, and then farm A is moving, right? So most likely you will see that they, when once they operate again and at Bitcoin price climbing, which might result in the demand of the hash rate getting higher. So I would encourage you to actually buy earlier before they change the price or something, like how I got this BTC mining for $110, I think. So I can show you if I can find. So these are my profits, so what I'm generating. So let's see if I purchased it. So when I bought the hash rate, you can tell that I spent about 0.87. Okay, so about 0.087 times 55,000 at present value. I actually spent 4,700. So it's very expensive. So I actually bought them. I actually exchanged this Bitcoin at 35,000. So I would say that right now, since Bitcoin is of higher value, and if you're holding some of it, I wouldn't mind that you actually invest a small proportion to actually try to gain some interest on it. Let's say you are a long-term hodler. So yeah, up to you guys. Great. So that's all. Thank you. And I hope that this is informative for all of you guys, and I'm being transparent. I'm not saying that, oh, this is the best platform, I'm earning a lot of money, I'm getting passive income. That's not what I'm trying to tell you. I'm trying to tell you the difficulties that I face. The actual ROI I got wasn't as high as I expected. But I think overall, I think if you give them some time, I believe they are doing well, because after all, they did not hide away. They actually announced it regularly about their relocation situation, and if there's any electricity adjustment, what will happen and all. So I think they are quite accountable for the things that they are doing. And yeah, hope to see you in the community. Goodbye.